It has been an incredible summer, as you know. There's a 2-week time gap between my last vlog and this episode, and for those of you that are wondering where I went, here's a little summary. I spent some time with a special expression of consciousness and fellow traveler, and explored the Redwood State Park near Humboldt. Lost Coast, Mount Shasta, the Umpqua area, Mount Rainier, Bend, Oregon, and finally the San Juan Islands. It was my first time visiting many of those areas, and the experiences combined with the presence of such an interesting person made it a journey I won't soon forget.
Wow, guys, so as you know, I've been all over the place for the last 2.5 weeks, I believe. Kind of lost track of time, but you guys saw a little snippet about where I've been, what I've been doing. I am close to Seattle. I just got off the ferry from the San Juan Islands. My car is a wreck. I hit a deer. I need to get this thing fixed. It's all kind of damaged on the outside. It's a wreck in here. It's dirty. My car is dirty. Probably going to clean this thing and get it fixed up right after I get it fixed up. But just got off the San Juan Islands. I'm near Seattle. I'm on my way all the way to Colorado to meet up with a buddy, Matthew. It is a 1,300-mile drive, 20 hours. I'm going to try and break it up into 2 10-hour days. I might do something insane and try and do it all in one shot. We'll see how I'm feeling. I don't know. But I'm on my way to Colorado right now. I've got a long drive, a lot of time in the car, which does not bother me at all. I've got a lot to process and think about, which I'm super happy about. And yeah, I'm going to catch you guys along the way and once I get landed in Colorado. So we'll see how this goes. Guys, I have no idea if you can see me, but I've been driving for almost 12 hours today, not quite 12 hours. It is midnight. I'm gonna call it a day. I've got another 12-hour day to go before I hit Boulder, Colorado. I'm in Boise, Idaho right now. Everything worked out perfectly as usual. I found like this truck stop with all these big ass trucks out here parked, and I am going to set my Jeep up to go to sleep back here real quick and try and get a couple hours of some shut-eye and then hit the road again. But so far so good, everything's smooth. We're on our way to Colorado. I'm headed to Boulder, Colorado to meet up with my buddy Matthew. We're gonna figure out what we need to do there. First, I need to get my oil changed and my tires rotated and possibly in alignment, among other things. I gotta take care of this Jeep because it's been taking care of me. But yeah, I'm gonna get some sleep and I'll catch you guys in the morning. Alright guys, I'm hitting the road again. I was able to get some sleep. This is a super busy truck stop, but I'm super happy I was able to get some sleep. Yeah, I gotta get out of here though, because I'm sure these guys are like, what in the hell is this guy doing? But yeah,
Time to hit the road. Got 12 more hours of driving to do today, but I will check in with you guys in a bit. Alright guys, so I've been driving for like 14 hours here, but I don't want to talk too much, just a bunch of people out over there, but anyway, I've been driving for like 14 hours and I'm here, pretty much here, only 40 miles outside of Boulder, Colorado, which is my destination. Yeah, I want to make some food and just chill out. I've been driving all day and I can definitely drive for 40 something minutes to an hour in the morning. First thing I'm going to do is get the oil changed and the tires rotated on this Jeep. Matthew is not going to be here until later in the day, so I have plenty of time to do other things I need to do. So yeah, I'm going to finish the day off right now, make some food and just chill out. So yeah, I'm here. I'm just in this church parking lot. When you're on the road, you gotta get creative for places to stay. I've got a pretty good gut for where to stay and different things like that. So we're gonna be staying here tonight. So, yeah, let's see what happens. I'll follow up with you guys tomorrow morning when I wake up and we'll see what I get into. Peace. Making these Beyond sausages. I committed to completely stopping eating meat a couple weeks ago. And, I'm not gonna lie, if I did not make the commitment to stop eating meat, I totally would have had fast food today. Being on the road for 13, 14 hours and they literally have only the lamest restaurants available, but I was super hungry. Only thing that kept me from getting like Carl's Jr. was the fact that I do not eat meat anymore, so super happy to be doing this right now. All right, you guys, so it's a new day here. I'm officially in Boulder. I just got the Jeep's oils changed and tires rotated, so I'm super happy about that. This thing is taking good care of me, so I gotta take care of my Jeep here. But yeah, I'm gonna run some errands. Got a bunch of stuff taken care of today in the waiting room. Had all kind of tickets and expired registrations and all kind of crap from LA that I had to take care of, so I handled that. Matthew's not gonna be in Boulder until later today. So I'm gonna head finish these errands up and yeah, check back in with you guys probably when I meet up with Matthew. So we'll see how this goes. All right guys, just a quick little update. So Matthew's not here yet. I'm actually gonna call him and see what's going on. I'm gonna head to a park, make some food, eat lunchtime. I just finished a bunch of errands. Not sure how big of a deal this is, but I'm officially got the iPhone 12 Pro Max here. Better photos, we'll see what happens. I'm gonna try and get into social with this stuff, but and the cool guy that worked in the Verizon store gave me some dope suggestions for things to check out here in the area, so I'm definitely gonna check those out. I'm headed to this park right now, so let's see what happens, but yeah, I'll check in with you guys when Matt gets here. All right guys, new day here. Finally got Matthew in the area. So we are here near Boulder, got a little campsite. We're gonna head into town to take care of some things. As you guys know, I need to get the Jeep repaired at a collision center, and I'm gonna decide today whether or not I'm just gonna go ahead and do that. That way we can spend our time around here and then we can you know, once the Jeep is fixed, we can figure out where we want to go just unhindered and just be able to flow freely. But yeah, we are here. Matt is with me and we are ready to go. So we're going to figure out what we're going to do and I'll check back in with you guys in a bit. All right, guys, so we're checking out Boulder Falls real quick, just a quick pit stop. Guys, new day here. We are on our way to Rocky Mountain National Park. All packed up, ready to go. Not sure what to expect, but we are gonna head up here and see what happens. Get a hike in or something, I don't know, we'll see. Unfortunately, you need a reservation to get into the park between 9 a.m. and 3 p.m., which we do not have, so we're going to look for another hike or something else around here. We're in a great area to do it, so I've got high hopes, and we'll see what we come up with. So that's the situation right now. All right, guys, we saw this cool little church on our way up here, so we're going to stop and check it out.
Okay, folks, this is Camp St. Malo, and it's owned by the Diocese of Denver. It is a functioning Catholic church. And a lot of people ask, why would they put a church in the middle of nowhere? Because this 160 acres here was a boys' camp.
Alright guys, we are on our way. We thought they were going to turn us away at the entrance, but we're on our way up here. Forgot the name of this hike, but it looks like it's going to be pretty beautiful. So far this seems pretty nice. So we're finally on our first hike in Colorado after much anticipation. Thank you. Look what Matthew found out here.
Wish I had a bag.
All right, guys, it's a new day. I kind of dropped off from yesterday after our hike, but we got into the Rocky Mountain National Park. You have to get in before 9 a.m. Otherwise, you need a reservation, which we don't have. We were lucky enough to get in. However, we came in here to find out that the probably the nicest half of the park is also reservation only. So they've kind of got this double reservation system, which, you know, whatever. But now we're just going to drive and see what we can find. Yesterday, we bumped into a really good hike. Randomly and unexpectedly, so I'm very confident that today that the same thing is going to happen. So we're going to go and just drive and see what happens and try and see where we end up. So I'll catch you guys in a bit. Alright guys, a little update here. So apparently the route that was open in Rocky Mountain National Park, since we didn't have a reservation to go the other direction, is pretty much just driving a bunch of traffic and touristy lookout spots like this. I've got a feeling that we're probably going to end up leaving the park and look for a hike outside of the park, which we should have no problem doing, but we're just getting out of the car. Matt took some shrooms, so he just wanted to get out and vibe a little bit, but that's where we're at now, so keep you guys updated and see how.
There's a marmot right there. You can see it. It's eating.
It was posing.
All right, give you guys a little update here. So dramatic change of plans. We are actually heading to Moab. So we are packing up right now.
Cannot wait.
The vibes in Colorado have kind of pushed us in another direction, and we are really looking forward to getting into Moab, but very appreciative of everything we've gotten to experience here in Colorado. So yeah, we are about to hit the road in a bit, and it's gonna take us around 5 hours to get there. So yeah, we'll see you guys in Moab.
As I stated earlier, I'm extremely thankful to have been able to spend some time in Colorado, but there was just something about the vibes from the day we got there that sent us in a different direction. If I could put my finger on it, I would definitely have to say it was a combination of the crowds, excessive reservations, restrictions, and the lack of access to a lot of the areas that we wanted to see originally. Regardless, in my life, any time spent living is time well spent. And I have no doubts about the magnitude of adventures that await us in Moab.